Hey, Brigitte, how was your day?
I don't know. I feel like I never have time for myself.
Haven't you been playing the cello?
No. How about you?
My day wasn't too bad. I was actually playing this really peaceful and calming song last night. No, it's back
and forth. I know how that feels. I always felt that way when I played the cello.
Wait, you've been here the whole time? So how does rhythm affect our mood? That is, why does me talking like this feel different emotionally than me talking like this?
That probably starts in utero, when the little fetus is developing. There's this rhythmic input. Our maternal heart rate, the aorta and the heart sort of tap on the diaphragm. And so three different sensory routes, vibration, touch, and sound, have this syncopated rhythm that's continuous. And so the brain essentially comes to connect patterned, repetitive, rhythmic sensory input with being safe and regulated.
That may be why we pace around before giving a big speech or tap our feet to a rhythm when we're nervous.
On top of the rhythm usually comes the melody, but what makes these melodies so powerful?
In one study, researchers scanned the brains of people who experienced chills while listening to music and those who did not. Those who experienced chills had a higher volume of white matter connectivity between auditory areas of the brain.
So, if you get chills while listening to Olivia Rodrigo's Driver's License, you're quite literally built different.
However, you might want to be careful about how much sad music you listen to.
I mean, who among us hasn't leaned against the car window while we blare melancholic music pretending to be the protagonist of our own movie? A study in Finland found that people who frequently listened to sad music had less activity in the area of the brain that is active during emotional regulation.
So, what about lyrics? How do they affect us?
When I work with clients to write songs, I often start with the words first with them before we get into the music.
This is Dr. Webb and Dr. Thomas, music therapists I spoke to about the significance of lyrics.
You know, or there's a song that's like, I am so sad right now. I don't have words for it, but this singer does, you know, or they reminding us we're not alone in whatever we're feeling.
Other people's words can help you express your own emotions and help you figure them all out.
So how do we use music to make us feel better in our daily lives?
One of the most powerful forms of regulating rhythm is created by movement. So I always recommend to anybody I work with where anxiety is part of the issue, think about how to dose it in a way that you're getting it in small bits more frequently.
Try taking breaks to do little rhythmic activities throughout the day.
They do calligraphy, they doodle in a lecture, graphic use of your hands, it's rhythmic. And it has the same rhythms as conversation, the same rhythms as being rocked as a baby.
And you can also try what Dr. Thomas calls the tunnel playlist.
If you think of the way that tunnels work, right, you go in and it gets really dark and then you come out, right, and there's the light at the end. So a lot of times in our like anxiety spirals or depression episodes, there's a moment when you know you're going into it. Then we think about, okay, when you're in the tunnel, when you're in those deepest, darkest moments, what music can help affirm where you are and not make you feel like there's pressure to get out of it, but just sort of be with you.
Growing up, I used to listen to a lot of music, and I would always kind of have like these intricate fantasies with each song I listened to. So I started to make playlists like that would be each season of my life. Then when the pandemic happened, I spent a lot more time learning guitar and songwriting. Music can help us make sense and relate to events and when we know that other people are going through it. So it kind of helps us feel seen. When everything comes together perfectly, it's just euphoria.
Well, I like it because it's easy for me to see improvement in myself, and I like being in the process of
noticing that my hearing is getting stronger. Because when I play and I really focus on a note or a section in a piece, I feel like coming back to it, I play it 10 times better. And I really like that experience. And it just makes me feel more empowered.
Music lets me know that I can get better.